Good evening. If you go to a restaurant, you generally know how much your meal is going to cost when you order.
But when you go to the hospital, you usually have no idea how much you're going to pay until the bill arrives in the mail. But that's all changing.
Consumer investigator Jennifer Krause tells us how you could benefit.
A new law that took effect January 1st says hospitals must now post their prices online. And the whole idea is more transparency and less sticker shock for you when you get the bill. Have you ever wondered how much it might cost to have an MRI of your chest? What about having your appendix removed? And did you know a heart transplant could set you back nearly $1 million? Those prices and thousands more are now listed on the websites of Nashville's hospitals. Thanks to a new federal law, the cost of all procedures and services must be posted online.
This is helpful for consumers to have this information.
Andy Spears, executive director of Tennessee Citizen Action, calls it a win for consumers. But as we found, getting the real information you need,
it was definitely confusing,
can be challenging. For starters, just finding the price list on the websites of the big three hospitals in town, run by Vanderbilt, St. Thomas, and TriStar, we discovered is tricky. And the price list itself can be just a long spreadsheet with lots of confusing abbreviations and code. On top of that, the hospitals all post lengthy disclaimers, informing consumers that the information given here does not necessarily represent what the actual cost will be or what the patient will owe, because that depends on whether the patient has insurance or not and whether the service provider is in or out of network.
And then it was difficult to find very specific procedures and what that typical cost would look like. And it was difficult to tell from one hospital to the next if you're paying for the exact same thing.
That perhaps is the most frustrating thing for Spears, that it's nearly impossible for consumers to be able to use this information to compare prices and find the best deal. When we checked the price of an EKG or electrocardiogram, which measures heart activity, we found, as you can see, a huge difference in price, though it's impossible to tell whether we were truly comparing apples to apples. Still, Spears believes posting this information is a good start, and he suggests that consumers check the price list and then call the hospital to get a more accurate and patient-specific quote.
I'm hopeful that as this process goes forward, hospitals will get better at the information they provide. Maybe their billing departments will get tired of answering questions, and they'll put more information out there.
And since it can be tricky, as we discovered, to find the prices, we've made it easy for you. Just go to our website and you'll find direct links to the price lists in town. Jennifer Krause, News Channel 5 Investigates.
When asked about the disparity in prices for an EKG, Vanderbilt told us late this afternoon that they offer several different types of EKGs, some at lower prices depending on a patient's needs. This just further shows how confusing and complex this process can be for consumers.